Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today I'm doing a special video here on the XRT. I kind of wanted to warn you guys about. I've gotten some questions here on the channel about battery placement with the XMAX and the XRT. I installed my battery the same way on both trucks. So I'm gonna show you how to do that now. This is very important because I have seen here on YouTube where people have had fires here with the XRT. I've seen other videos too as well where they talk about how if you place your battery a certain way, it could create a pinch point and it can actually cut or damage your battery lines while you're driving, and that could be, you know, a cause of a fire. These are the batteries that I run in my XRT. These are Traxxas batteries, the 4S6700s. Now you may be running a different type of battery, but this still may help you out. This is the way that works for me. So we're gonna go ahead and get started here. One thing you do not wanna do, trust me, I know from personal experience. You see this battery here? There's some electrical tape on there because I'd actually nicked one of these lines installing the battery like this when I first ran the XRT. And I've since learned from that, I do not wanna destroy my batteries, and I sure as hell don't want my XRT going up in flames. So trust me guys, you do not want to install your batteries like this with the connector going inwards. If you see here where you latch that door down, that's a pinch point. Even if you move your cords out of the way and you latch that battery down, I'm not going to demonstrate it here because I don't want to damage my battery, but even if you latch this door down with the cord out of the way, it's still a pinch point. If you look here in the battery tray on both sides, not just this end, but this end as well, they're both the same. Not only do you have a pinch point, but you also have here a sharp edge where that cord may hit and can actually damage or cut your battery lines there. Now, like I said, I did originally, the first time I ran this truck, I ran my batteries like that and I really wasn't paying attention. I got it locked down, you know, I kept the lines or the connectors out of the way when I latched it down, of course, but I really wasn't paying attention to that. And then after I ran my XRT, I noticed on this battery right here that has electrical tape, I had a nick in one of these lines where the actual wire, the metal wiring was exposed. So I covered it with electrical tape. I'm still not sure if I'm gonna continue to use this battery. If you guys watch my videos, you know I'm very particular with my batteries. I don't fool around with batteries. They can be dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. You don't want to cause a fire or damage anything or hurt yourself. So I take batteries really serious, and I'm always maintaining my batteries. So I'm not sure if I'm going to continue to use this one, but just for the purpose of the video here, I want to show you how I install my batteries. Now this is the same for the XRT and the XMAX. The way that Traxxas tells you in the manual to install your battery is with the connector at the end of the truck like this. Again, you don't wanna install your battery with a connector facing this pinch point, but even if you did it outwards, which is the way I run my batteries, it's gonna be a tight reach. Once you get this battery tray down, it's gonna be a tight reach. And then your ESC connectors are hanging over a hot motor. Now that's not to say that this motor will get that hot where it'll damage your wires, but I don't want to take the risk, do you? So the way I do it is I install my batteries with the cord facing out of the truck. You run it through the battery hold down, straighten your battery up, and lay it down in the tray like so. Okay, now that the battery is laid down in the tray, you can see that my cord is out of the truck. And there's a little hole here that allows for my battery cable to hang out freely. There's no pinch point, and I can fully latch the battery down, and I don't have to worry about my lines getting cut. Whereas if I had the lines on this side, I mean, that's a real tight spot, guys, right there. A real, real tight spot. And, you know, even in my situation, it did damage my battery, sticking them in there like that. So I would suggest you stick your batteries with the connector out. And again, we're gonna run this cable through the battery hold down like so. And this time you'll notice that the Traxxas logo is face down. I had to do this so that I can get this cord facing out of the truck. Again, make sure your wires are clear. Go ahead and latch them down. And then you can connect over the battery hold downs like so. And that's how I run my truck, guys. Again, I wasn't really paying attention the first time I ran the XRT. I was kind of in a hurry. I should have been more careful. This is normally how I run my X-Max. I just threw the batteries in there and went along with it. Again, this is not the end-all be-all. This is just the way I do it. Everybody does things differently, but this is the way that works best for me when I install my batteries. Now, if you run it the way Traxxas says, you can run it with these cords sticking out of the truck like we have them here now. And if you want to run them with the connectors on this end, you can do that. But again, it's going to be kind of a tight fit. It'll work because I've tried it. It'll be a tight fit once you connect the ESC lines to the battery. You don't want to be doing a ramp jump, you know, and the battery disconnects because, you know, these cables barely reach. Now here they reach fine with the batteries facing towards the front of the truck, connectors out. So again, I just wanted to make this video to answer some questions that we had here on the channel. All right, guys, just to show you real quick, say you're done running the truck now and you're ready to remove the batteries. It's real easy. Start here at the bottom of the battery and just raise up. Take your time. You don't want to tear or damage your connector here, and just take it out like so. It's not that hard once you get used to it. It gets easier. It is kind of tedious in the beginning, but I'm telling you, if you run your batteries that way, it is a whole lot safer in my opinion. That's all I got for this video, guys. Hopefully it was informative. Hit me up with any questions if you got any. If maybe you know of a better way to install the batteries, feel free to let us know here in the comments. Again, this is just the way I do it. It works out for me a whole lot better this way, and I don't have to worry about destroying my batteries or my truck going up in flames. So with that being said, guys, I appreciate you watching. That's all I got, and I'll see you on the next one. Later.